Good morning. Today we'll be celebrating St. Peter Chrysologus, Bishop and Doctor of the Church. We have his homilies from the 5th century, and so as a patron of preachers, we pray that he will bless all who preach God's word to us. We will chant two verses of God, We Praise You. God, we praise you. God, we bless you. God, we name you, Sovereign Lord, Mighty King, whom angels worship, Father by your church adored. All creation shows your glory. Heaven and earth draw near your throne, singing, Holy, 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 Lord of hosts and God alone. True apostles, faithful prophets, saints who set their world ablaze, martyrs once unknown, unheeded, join one growing song of praise. While your church on earth confesses one majestic Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, God our hope eternally. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My sisters, my brothers, we celebrate St. Peter Chrysologus. We pray that God will continue to make us all evangelizers, all messengers of good news, and that God will put his word deep within us. Sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who made the bishop, St. Peter Chrysologus, an outstanding preacher of your incarnate word, grant through his intercession that we may constantly ponder in our hearts the mysteries of your salvation and faithfully express them in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord. Come, go down to the potter's house, and there I will let you hear my words. So I went down to the potter's house, and there he was, working at his wheel. The vessel he was making of clay was spoiled in the potter's hand, and he reworked it into another vessel, as seemed good to him. Then the word of the Lord came to me. Can I not do this with you, O house of Israel, just as this potter has done? Says the Lord. Just like the clay in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are they whose help is the God of Jacob.
Blessed are they whose help is the God of Jacob.
Praise the Lord, O my soul. I will praise the Lord as long as I live. who made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is in them.
Blessed are they whose help is the God of Jacob.
Alleluia.
Jesus said to the crowds, "The kingdom of heaven is like a net that was thrown into the sea and caught fish of every kind. When it was full, they threw it ashore, sat down, and put the good in the baskets, but threw out the bad. So it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come out and separate the evil from the righteous and throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Have you understood all this?" They answered, "Yes." And Jesus said to them, "Therefore, every scribe who has been trained for the kingdom of heaven is like the master of a household who brings out of his treasure what is new and what is old." The Gospel of the Lord.
St. Peter was the bishop of Ravenna, a city in Italy I'd still like to go see. I told you I was able to visit Rome when Father Peter was studying there, and he wanted to go back to Siena, where he'd done his Italian studies, which was fine by me. I didn't have much connection with Siena, but we were able to go to Florence, a city that I studied at King's. And so it was wonderful to be able to see this place that I'd only thought of, heard of, seen pictures of before. But Ravenna holds a great draw for me. You understand in the history when the empire fell in the west, that in the east it lasted for another 1,000 years, the quote-unquote Holy Roman Empire. And so the emperor's representative lived in Ravenna, and so they say it's the most eastern Greek kind of city. Different looking churches, different architecture, different sense to it. So the city of St. Peter Chrysologus is worthy of our attention, not just his remarkable homilies. Again, how wonderful that from the 5th century we have these homilies. I want to share one little reflection with you on peace. I think it might be good for us in these very troubled times to have an insight. It was new to me. I hope it's as fruitful for you. Please excuse the exclusive language. Again, he's writing in the 5th century. "Peace, dearest brethren, rescues man from servitude, provides him with the name of a free man, changes his identity before God, together with his condition, from a servant to a son, from a slave to a free man. Peace among brethren is the will of God, the joy of Christ, the completion of holiness, the rule of justice, the teacher of truth, the guardian of morals, and a praiseworthy discipline in every regard. Peace lends strength to our prayers. It is the way our petitions can reach God easily and be credited. It is the plenitude which fulfills our desires. Peace is the mother of love, the bond of concord, and the manifest sigh of a pure soul, one which seeks to please God, which seeks to be fulfilled, and has its desire rewarded." Peace is the triumph of justice. We've lived through the Cold War, which was not peace. If you can remember the insanity of Western system, as John Paul said, there's one America, north, south, but we were happy to overthrow a government. We're happy to install a brutal dictator like Marcos in the Philippines or Noriega in Panama. And we thought, oh, because these people hate communists, they'll be good. Good for us. And we learned of their brutality. We learned how they stole their people, robbed their people's blind. How on earth did we think that would somehow serve justice and peace? Peace is our new identity. It moves us from slave to child. How remarkable. Peace is the fulfillment of our prayers, makes them better. What a great insight. If we want to be in a healthier world, if we want to be better disciples, we want to be a better person of prayer, it must be peace. To live in a world of insanity, to live in a world of injustice, why should I think that shouldn't make my prayers futile? My thinking, my world, the system I'm part of, excuse me. What a wonderful gift, St. Peter Chrysologus, from the 5th century. Let's commit ourselves to being people of peace who live in a peaceful, just world today. Please stand. We pray for the church throughout the world, for our Holy Father, the Pope, for all bishops, for all who lead us, that the church will everywhere be an agent for peace. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all who work for peace, the members of the Canadian Armed Forces, all diplomats, that our nation might strive for peace. In every way, we pray to the Lord. We pray for preachers, that God will continue to raise up many servants of the word and the altar to shepherd God's people and lead them in the ways of truth. We pray to the Lord. We pray for the intentions each one of us brings to this Mass, especially for the intentions of Steve Meidiger and Virginia Denemy, thanksgiving for 64 years of Christian marriage with Gerard and Mary Ducharme. For God's continued blessings in all our lives, we pray to the Lord. We pray for our sick, those who suffer in body or mind, especially today, all those suffering from cancer. God will give all his people healing and peace. We pray to the Lord. We pray for those who have died, especially Cecilia Farwell. God will give all his faithful departed eternal rest. We pray to the Lord. God, our Heavenly Father, we praise and thank you for calling us to be preachers of peace. Continue to pour out your Spirit, your good word among all your people. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, which earth has given, human hands have made, it will come for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my sisters, my brothers, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord
look with favor, O Lord, we pray, on the offerings we set upon this sacred altar on the feast day of Blessed Peter Chrysologus, that bestowing on us your pardon, our oblations may give honor to your name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Peter you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, Ronald, our Bishop, Joseph, his auxiliary, and all those who hold into the truth, and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, Mary and Gerard Ducharme, Stephen Pat Meiniger, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, are they offered for themselves and all who are dear to them. For the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. With eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. Once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection till you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants, Cecilia Farwell, who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. The power, the glory. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Amen.
Let us offer one another a sign of God's peace. Lamb of God, forgive the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Please stand. Let us pray. Renewed by the sacred mysteries, we humbly pray, O Lord, that following the example of blessed St. Peter Chrysologus, we may strive to profess what he believed and to practice what he taught through Christ our Lord. So, Mary and Jerry, I'll give you a blessing. I'm having some problems, so I'll have to do it from here. But only in the understanding that you return in a year's time with Father Gary and celebrate your 65th. That's remarkable. God bless you both. Bow your heads. If you are comfortable, join me in extending your hands in prayer
and blessing for our friends. Almighty God, your faithful love has kept our brother and sister Gerald and Mary together to this very day. And we thank you for your faithfulness and pray that that same love will guide them, fill them, and give them many more years of happy Christian marriage. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Well done. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Jesus Christ, the King of glory, everlasting Son of God, humble was your virgin mother, hard the lonely path you trod. By your cross is sin defeated, hell confronted face to face, heaven open to believers, sinners justified by grace. Christ at God's right hand victorious, you will judge the world you made. Lord, in mercy, help your servants, for whose